no is. First of all, and what has actually hindered many is that what you know about God is what keeps us in the journey of life. Praise God. Ask Abraham, he will tell you God is El Shaddai, the provider. When God asked him to go and sacrifice his son, and he was about to sleep, to sacrifice his son, God said, don't touch the land. Look under that tree. Go and use that tree. He's not just saying it from what he read. He's not just saying it from what he had. It's experience. Praise God. Praise the living Jesus. For Moses, he said, who should I say for me? He said, tell them I am that I am. Praise God. Praise the living Jesus. So the knowledge you know about him determines what you do for him and what he will do for you. Praise the living Jesus. I may know brother, I may know sister, I may know anybody, but if I'm not close, as I don't have this close relationship with them, we only be saying each other, good afternoon, good morning, good evening. That does not mean I know everything about him. For the fact that you know President Muhammadu Buhari is from Daura, you know his house, you know his network, you know everything about him, does not mean you'll be able to assess him. So what you know about God determines what you will do for him and what he will do for you. God will not go ahead to do what you don't know about him for you. That's why he has to send these people. He will have just arrived, say, tell my people. I will have just arrived, go to Egypt himself and deliver them, but they will not know him. That's why he has to tell them I am that I am. Praise God. Praise the living Jesus. Praise the living Jesus. So, the knowledge of God is not about what we think. It's not about what we think we know about him. It's about who he is, our experience with him. Our experience with him. It's a challenge to this generation when we tell stories of our fathers. Who prayed and made things happen? And we are hearing of this generation who watch things happen. They pray to make things happen. They know what yesterday that they make things happen. But in this generation, we only watch things happen, looking for people who make things happen. Praise the living Jesus. So of course you will wonder, why is this guy here this morning? I bring greetings from my father in the Lord and the president of the house, Pastor Ibeti of Victor Ibotalo, is not around, is on assignment. Praise God. So let's appreciate God in his life too. It's my father in the Lord. May God help us all in Jesus' name. So the knowledge of God you have determines how far you go in him. It's not about what you hear, it's about what you experience. I will not just call everybody, come and define God. You will divide God according to what dictionary says. You will divide God according to what you read. But that does not define who he is in your life. So this one will be talking briefly on who is your God. Who is your God? Who is your God? We have different gods. I want to know that you are calling God. Who is God in your life? Let's open to the book of John 2017. Praise God. Who is that God in your life? John 2017 was when God was telling that man. He said, I have not yet ascended. I have not seen my father. He said, now you are ascending to my God, to my father and your father. My God and your God. Now, he said, my own God, but it's also your God. But who is that your God? This is the challenge to us. The book of 1 Kings chapter 18, 24 and 25. 1 Kings 18, 24 and 25. He said, okay, I'm the only prophet here. We have about 40 prophets of Baal. Now, the God who answers by fire, let him be what? Let him be God. Praise God. Who is your own God? Elijah, know his God. Ask Elijah, who is God? We tell you God is fire. Amen. Elijah was given the title, he was not done on fire, because he knows a God who is fire. Pastor, I'm not telling you, I was telling you something some times ago. He said, you don't give the word of knowledge until you know the God who has all knowledge. So it is the same thing that I will give you the knowledge of things you don't know. Abina, so if you don't know the God who has all knowledge, you don't give the word of knowledge. Anyone giving us the God that gives the word is word from knowledge. Praise God. Praise the living Jesus. Praise the living Jesus. So I was telling them, okay, kill the wood. Make an altar, but don't put fire. Set everything in place, but don't put fire. And call upon your God. If your God answer, he will be God. But if my God answer, he will be God. They cried, they prayed, they did many things. Their God was unable to answer. They only know him to be what they will worship. They don't know him personally, but Elijah knows his God. Elijah prayed. He prayed and said, if I be a man of God, let fire fall. He knows what? He knows his God. In this place, he said, Lord, so that Israel may know that you are God. I know already, but so that Israel will know, so that the people here, witness this occasion, will know that you are God. I'm asking you now, I'm asking you, sir, who is your own God? Where is the God going to present to your generation? Is he a God you know from afar? The book of Acts 17:22 was saying something about Paul and his companions in missionary. Some people now put another, they wrote to their unknown God. Are you serving an unknown God? I've been a Christian since I was a child. It is possible you know your father's church. You know your mother's church, but you don't know their God. But who is God? Praise the living Jesus. Now, they asked the children this same question. He said, why do you like sleeping like this? Everybody is perishing. You are still sleeping. Better call upon your God. Maybe you answer. Now your God. Situation will arise in life. Many things will happen that you will ask that you call upon your God. Which kind of God do you want to call on? Praise God. What is the name of the God you want to call on? The Lord is a provider. Do you know him as a provider? Or they tell you? Praise God. They ask verses 2. If they ask me, you already even know they will ask him. If they ask me, what should I say? They will ask you too as a believer. Situations in life are arising and will still arise that will require that you call upon your God. Who is now your God? Praise the living Jesus. Who is now your God? At times, believer will come. There's nothing that he can become. Amen. Let's just start. But for now, praise God. Don't that for now when you have a God. Praise God. The God you serve should determine the word you speak. Pastor Paula Kondelano said something some times ago. He said, your condition, your situation should not determine your utterance. Praise the living Jesus. So who is the God? Who is the God you know? Jesus said, he's my God and he's your God too. I know him as my God, but he's your God. When situation arises, when they will call your God, it means they are expecting something from you. Call that God. Let that God speak. Let that God say whatever I want to say. Let's see his salvation. Let's see his might. Let's see his power. Who is your God? When there's no
finances is somehow, when your academics is going the other way around.